Hello everybody, Angel Arts here. Welcome back to another episode of Gay Let's Play Dragon Age Inquisition. Right now we are still in the southern part of the Ferelden map, but we're starting to get to the southwestern area. I'm not really sure which Templar camp exactly we're supposed to be getting, but... because we went to the big castle thing. I think I'll come back here later. Because I don't see any marks right now that's telling us to go one way or another. So let's go to the farms and see if we can find anything of interest. Jeez, lots of bodies everywhere. Maybe I'll be able to do that Templar camp quest when I actually have a mount. Horse or something. Austrian. Alright, so now I have to find a way to get up there. Gotta keep looking. Because the Austrian is somewhere. It looks like it might be up that mountain somewhere. Ooh.
Your defense is prepared ahead. Prepare yourself.
I'm prepared. Stay back. Zap them. Yes, just in time. Your potions are up. Oh yeah, thank you. That barrier is very well needed. Oh. I need a barrier too. Very squishy. Yeah, that hit was really hard. Whoa! Woo! It's a good thing he froze. Thank you! There's a lot of these guys here. I think I need to reapply. There you go, Cassandry. Fire! Having two of us being able to put down barriers is very key. Woo! Very nice. Of our great sword. That one was a pretty challenging fight. Spider totem, lustrous claw, jagged battle axe. All right. Maybe this is what's gonna lead me up there? Maybe? I see you, Embryum. Alright, let's see if we can climb our way. Ah, yes, this is the way. Jeez. Do you mind? Pick that. Are you okay there? Ooh, Varric almost went down. Use your potions. We have plenty, plus your regeneration potion. Here. Nicely done. Well played, guys. Well played. Hunter mail. Nug foot charm. I love that. Instead of rabbit's foot charm, because nugs are supposed to be a cross between a pig and a bunny. This is not the way. I know that you're here. This way? This way. Maybe? Oh, come on. Really? Come on. Maybe I'm not supposed to go up this way. This is not where the stairs are. The Astrarium is right there. I feel like I keep getting away from it, though. That looks like it would look like it was our best way to get up there. Hafter's Woods. We need to kill Ram, right? Yeah, I think we do need to get Ram for food. I think so, right? Ram meat. Yep, we need ram. Okay. That Astrarium. I'm still kind of puzzled as to how to get up there. Oh, wow. Crystal Grace. Is that related to Andraste's Grace? The flower Andraste's Grace? I'm wondering. Ooh, our potions are running a little bit low. Oh, there we are. I was like, I knew there was a way. Knew there was. I just, you know, had to figure it out. Just had to explore a bit more. Ooh, here we go. And after this, we need Sturdy Coat. Keen Blight Wasp Vitar Raider Hatchet. Let's check out this Vitar. Okay, a little bit better. And doesn't go all over our face. Do I need to update your weapon, Cassandry? Requirement level 9. Yeah. No, you're fine. Find what you have. Okay, let's check this out. The Astrarium. Ooh, this one's a little more complicated.
But doable.
Yeah. Is there an extra one? Looks like there's an extra one. Yeah. We just threw that in just because. Oh, wait a minute. That's weird. That's not the shape. It's wrong. Yeah, there's supposed to be another star here. Oh. Restart. Okay, I was like, what the heck? I needed to move the camera, that's why. I was wondering about that. Okay. Down here. Down there. Ah, now we're good. There we go. Was like a dragon. Finish. Constellation Draconis, called High Dragon in common parlance. The constellation Draconis is always depicted by a dragon in flight. Recently, it has come into question whether this was the case in the ancient Imperium. Most of inter-dragon imagery was reserved for the old gods, so why would they dedicate a constellation to dragons in general when specific dragons were held in such reverence? The speculation is fueled by older drawings showing Draconis as more serpentine in appearance, perhaps depicting a sea creature or an unknown eighth old god that was stricken from historical record. From a study of the Theodosian astronomy by Sister Oran Petrarchius. That's interesting. Whoa. One more. Alright. Yeah, and now we have another camp. Okay. All in a day's work. So much to do in these worlds. So massive. They were not... BioWare was not kidding around, guys. They were not playing around with this. Alright, let's head towards this camp thing over here. We can go... Well, let's go... We can go a little bit of a scenic route. This music. Landmark. Claim. The Saga of Tyrda Brightaxe Avar Mother. 8th stanza. Thydra Brightaxe, Avar chieftain. Strong, her tribe with dwarven trade. Battles brought to men and demons, one with wisdom, fire, and blade. Then did Tyrda look to Hendir, dwarf prince friend, children giver. Took her freedom, held in glad, wished for what he could not give her. Those chose her children to stand as chieftain, after all last wrongs were righted. Gifted goods of worldly want left her tribe no more benighted. Skyward, one last trek she made, to her lover dream delivered. Raven-feathered, reunited, hearts both whole and neither aching. Cool. Got a nice chest here. Sledgehammer. And Blight guitar again. The same guitar as before. And we've got something in here. Cool. More schematics. Alright. And there's a campsite over here. Looks like there's a bunch of enemies here too. And a ram. If I can shoot him from between here, that would be perfect. Perfect. Nice. A little bit defense. Ooh. Solus. Oh, your wall's not up. Throw us a barrier. Barrier's off. Ow. Yeah, Solas, you need to get out of there. Yeah, my barrier's not up yet. There we go. Where's my barrier? I need potions. We're about to get to a camp anyway. Barrier. Whew. Would you mind?
We should push ahead. Ooh. I doubt that was the last of them.
Yeah, I doubt it too. Battle axe, more things to sell. Ah! You punk! You punk. You guys just came out of nowhere. Now I know why you said I don't think that's the last of them. Not by a long shot. Alright, our tank really needs it. Well, a tank can have a regeneration potion. You can have a regeneration potion. I'm gonna have a regular potion. Nice. This is why we got elf roots, so we can replenish those. Robari token. Oh, jeez. Really? Where did you guys come from? Come on, you guys. There we go. Sheesh. Canine leather. And more canine leather. And more canine leather. And there's still a ram there that we need to take care of. Barracks going hunting. Wow, that just... At least he went quickly. That was pretty humane. Oh, I didn't get any... Alright, well. Oh, I didn't get any loot, any meat from him. That was the whole point. Ugh. Full draw. Panicked. There we go. Come on. Fire. Okay. As we were saying, get that ram. All right. We need some ram meat. Okay, 7 more. Was this one up here too? Yeah, I think it is. 6 more. Nice. Alright. There's a caravan wagon looking thing. Hitting F is definitely a lot easier, it seems, than hitting right click. What the heck? Hey! Not fair! Where are you guys coming from? There we go.
Whew. Have you been taking notes on all this, Varric?
Mm. Oh, you'll need to be more specific there, Seeker.
The Inquisition. You're not planning to write a book about us, are
probably.
You?
Oh,
don't get your hopes up. You're not that interesting a subject.
Mm-hmm. I don't know, Varric. Give me some time. I think I would... A Canary hero of Ferelden? Or at least hero of Thedas? That would be quite a story to tell. Especially after your experiences with Canary from before. I'm surprised that, I guess Varric doesn't have specific, you know, prejudices over or anything. Not that I'm aware of, at least. Still, the Canary did give him give him a pretty decent reason of not really trusting them. Oh, we could get more meat. Varric, you probably do this more humanely. Hold still. Oh, there's a whole bunch of them. Where'd you guys... Oh, come on, you guys. Don't be like that. That's not gonna hit. I'm trying. Sorry, guys. Good thing it doesn't res. Yeah. No, I want to keep that one. There you go. What the heck? What the heck? Jeez. Oh my gosh, from behind. That does it. Varric, here. Come on, Varric. Come on, buddy. Take a potion, Varric. Oh, jeez. I'm trying to get these rams, for goodness sakes. This one's not friendly. Oh, 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 whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa. You better put up a wall, Solas. Self-defense, the bear was attacking us. A lot of matter beasts are out, about and about. Meanwhile, the ram, which is what we were trying to kill in the first place, is out in the distance, just staring at us, going, oh, what are you guys up to? There we go. We're getting close to level 6. A Mabari? Oh no, Mabari. Oh.
There we go.
He gave his life so others can eat. Now what? Oh! I saw that coming. Or rather, I didn't see that coming. Sheesh! These bandits are everywhere. I don't have any more potions left, Solas. I'm sorry. I'm just gonna have to make do. Sheesh.
Mages and Templars fighting everywhere. Great job, Blondie.
Yeah, I know. Great job, stupid sexy Anders. I think we're about halfway. No, we only need three more. Good. We're still not that low health. Yeah, I know. Still trying to get to that campsite. There's more of those wolf things. Just gonna try to ignore them for now. Because I really need to get to a camp. Because we're starting to use up all our potions, so... Here we go. Uh-huh.
We could make camp here?
Very nice.
By the end of Hardin Hightown, almost every character is revealed as a spy or a traitor.
Mm.
Wait, you read my book?
It was in the Inquisition library. Everyone but Donnan turned out to be in disguise. Is that common?
Are we still talking about books, or are you asking if everyone I know is a secret agent?
Are there many tricksters in Dwarven literature?
A handful, but they're the exception. Mostly they're just honoring the ancestors. It's very dull stuff. Human literature. Now there's where you'll find the tricky, clever, really deceitful types.
Curious.
No, not really. Dwarves write how they want things to be. Humans write to figure out how things are.
Interesting. That's really interesting, Beric. Set up camp. Hooray. More influence. I don't know if the requisitions officer has anything. I don't think they do.
Nothing to report, sir.
All right, well, let's rest. Right, equip some potions. We need us more. More lyrium. More of that. Okay. Cool. Alright, now we can continue. What is this? Rifts in the woods. Active rifts have been spotted in Hafter's woods. Alright, well. We can go after that. Do that real quick. Oh, there's a random chest here by the camp. Thank you. Got a lot of gold. A lot of stuff we can sell, too. Yeah, I was trying to remember, because they had, they made elves be more traditionally barefoot in Dragon Age 2, so I was wondering if elves were necessarily barefoot in this one as well. I guess your Inquisitor, if it was an elf, doesn't necessarily have to be barefoot. Or I could be wrong. Maybe he does. He or she does. There we go. Last time we had the element of surprise instead. Oh, here's more. Love this. Playing as Varric is fun. Bianca's just such an awesome weapon. Reinforced defender armor. Ooh. Nice. I love the fact that Beric can now move while attacking with his crossbow. And archers in general can move while attacking. That's really a good touch. Because I would think you should be able to. Alright. Give Cassandra her, reinforced defender armor, I guess. Oh, she needs to be level 6. Alright, well that's something to move up towards. Is the shield not here? Maybe not. Thought I saw another shield. Alright, well anyway. Thank you guys for watching this episode of Gay Let's Play Dragon Age Inquisition. Tune in next time, everybody, and until then, love yourselves and love each other.